Hundreds of millions of people worldwide live in areas controlled by criminal organizations. These groups impose large economic and social costs that hinder growth and development. But when organized crime has been entrenched for years, if not centuries, what can states do to regain control? This paper evaluates the long-run impact of one of the most aggressive policies aimed at combating organized crime in Italy, the City Council Dismissal, or CCD. In municipalities where there are allegations of mafia infiltration in local government, CCDs empower the central government to dismiss the entire local political apparatus in an attempt to sever ties to organized crime. A team of external commissioners are then appointed to administer the municipality for 2 to 3 years until new elections take place. Since their introduction in 1991, there have been 245 CCDs, with the bulk concentrated in southern Italy, where the mafia emerged at the end of the 19th century. To assess the effectiveness of these policies, and in particular, their economic impact, the authors use confidential social security data, which allow them to track employment and firm entry and exit for the universe of non-agricultural firms. They estimate causal effects by matching each municipality where a CCD occurred to an observationally similar municipality that never experienced a CCD. Each treated and controlled pair is matched on multiple dimensions, including population, employment, and industry makeup, and note that because of a strict procedure intended to limit abuse, CCDs are not triggered by poor economic performance. The key finding is that CCDs spur economic activity. This figure compares employment in treated versus control municipalities in the years leading up to and following a CCD. In the pre-period, there is no significant difference between treated and control, but post-CCD, there is a clear change. Employment increases modestly in treated areas for the first 2 years before turning sharply upwards. This timing coincides with the end of the commissioner's mandate and the convening of a newly elected city council. In the long run, employment is 16.9% higher in treated municipalities. CCDs also increase the stock of firms in treated areas by 9.4% after 9 years, and the underlying data reveal that this reflects an increase in firm entry that outpaces an increase in firm exit. Increases on both margins are indicative of a greater economic dynamism caused by the CCD, and, consistent with this, there is a 15% increase in industrial real estate prices. What drives these effects? The primary intent of a CCD is to weaken the mafia's power, but it's possible the resulting stimulative effects are attributable to other factors. CCDs might generate economic growth by increasing the amount of central government transfers that flow to treated municipalities, or by substituting local politicians with experienced bureaucrats from the center. In other words, by re-centralizing power. However, the authors find that CCDs do not increase central government transfers, there is little evidence they have any impact on local fiscal policy, and to the extent the effects can be attributed to better management of local government, we should see similar patterns of economic growth when looking at CCDs caused by instances other than mafia infiltration. But these figures show that mafia-unrelated CCDs have only modest economic effects. A back-of-the-envelope calculation suggests that the re-centralization channel can explain only 20% of the effects observed in mafia-related CCDs. Instead, the balance of evidence suggests that CCDs generate economic growth precisely because they erode the mafia's power. For one, mafia-related CCDs change who runs the municipality after the dismissal. Post-CCD elected politicians are younger, more educated, more likely to be first-time politicians, and women. These are all factors that have been shown in other research to be associated with less corruption. In addition, there are several indicators that CCDs weaken the mafia's ability to enforce its economic monopolies. Post-CCD, there are fewer links between politics and business, as evidenced by a reduction in the share of politicians who are contemporaneously connected to private sector firms. The employment effects of CCDs are particularly large among young workers, who are disproportionately more likely to be recruited by criminal organizations. And the surge in the entry of new firms is concentrated in sectors traditionally associated with a strong mafia presence. All three signs point to the mafia's diminished economic influence post-CCD. Finally, the authors show that when CCDs fail to reduce the mafia's presence, they are also unable to generate significant economic outcomes. In some municipalities, politicians who were dismissed by the CCD are ultimately re-elected a few years later when new elections are held. The re-election of corrupt politicians is a sign that the mafia maintains a strong local presence, and these figures show that the positive economic effects of CCDs are entirely absent in these municipalities. Thus, this paper argues that CCDs stimulate economic growth by eroding the power of the mafia. These results shed light on strategies for re-establishing control in areas governed by organized crime. Previous studies have shown that cracking down on illegal activities, such as money laundering and drug trafficking, can have unintended consequences. These findings suggest an alternative may be targeting and rebuilding trust in corrupt institutions. To read more on this topic, you can check out the paper's references to other related work. This includes papers studying efforts to fight organized crime, including other work on CCDs, as well as research on the economic effects of organized crime and corruption more generally.